Motorfietsen met sy-spanne roep sterk beelden op. Jy denkt aan zwart en wit foto's van die Tweede Wereldoorlog. Of vrygeestige paarkies, romantisch op die oop pad, valhelm, bril op die kop. Daar is onderneming in die Kaap wat hierdie lyriese ervaring weer aan toeristen biedt, wat iets van hierdie bijna vergete avontuur wil beetkry. En eenmaal een jaar doen hulle iets extra speciaal. Therese was daar.
Hierdie is Tim Clark. En hierdie is sy reisgenoot en gelukbringer, Brody. Op een stadium in sy lewe het Tim in Asie gewoon en gewerk en hier het die sy-span gogga omgebuit en nooit gelos nie. Soveel so dat hy later een besigheid van sy passie begin het. Wat is het van sy-span motorfietsen wat jy so lief het?
Well, you know, these bikes are very old. They were built in the 1950s, 1960s and made in the communist era in China. So they're almost hand-built and they all named after ladies because they all are very special machines in my life.
Wat maak so'n motorfiets anders as 'n gewone motorfiets?
You have to know what the difference is. Bikers who come along and want to drive the bikes always say, well, I'm an expert, I can drive it. But a sidecar has different needs and different skills. Yeah. Because it has three wheels, your cornering is different, your leaning.
En wat het jou toe laat besluit om 'n besigheid hiermee te begin, Tim?
Well, when I returned from China, I ran a small business there. I didn't really know what to do with myself in Cape Town, so I decided to bring in a container load of these bikes just to see what we could do. And the idea of possibly taking visitors around our beautiful Cape Town was one idea that stuck. We started 15 years ago and we have now 31 of these bikes. I have my own drivers who drive for me part-time, and these guys are a mix of students, self-employed people, ladies, men, people from different walks of life.
Is dit uniek in Suid-Afrika as jy die enigste besigheid wat sulke sy-span motorfietsen verhuur?
There are smaller businesses, but we like to think of ourselves as the pioneers of the business around the world. I think we can claim to be the biggest sidecar adventure tour operators in the world.
Jo. Ek moet vra van Brody. Vertel my Brody se story.
Brody, King Brody. Now he is probably the best marketing manager I've ever had. Brody's a rescue dog from the dog organization in Heart Bay. Joined us as a little six-week pup, and he was the depot dog. So he loves sidecars, and he loves to be in them, and he gets all upset if he doesn't go for a ride. And he's just got a wonderful, wonderful nature. My drivers all thought that they were very important because people were hooting and waving, but it wasn't for the drivers of the bikes, it was for Brody.
Eenmaal een jaar bied Tim se sy-span besigheid die geleentheid aan een groep ouders en hulle gestremde kinders om ook op een sy-span rit te gaan.
Ek het die voorreg gehad om Deidre Gower te ontmoet so 3 jaar terug en sy het op hierdie avonture begin uitgaan met haar Sienkie Damien. En South Warrior on Wheels, het sal nou December 3 jaar wees begin en elke keer as hulle op een avontuur uitgaan het ek net saam gegaan en dan doen ek 'n bietjie die sosiale media kant.
Hoekom is 'n uitstapie soos vandag enigszins nodig?
Wat ons uitvind is dat die ouers soms baie ongemaklik voel om hulle kinders wat nie ons praat van hulle is anders toegerus as 'n normale kind, as ek het so kan sê. En baie keer is dit 'n baie emosionele situasie vir 'n ouer om die kind in die openbaar uit te vat. En Warrior on Wheels se avonture is so dat dit vir hulle 'n maklike, veilige plek is. En hulle gaan uit as 'n groep en hulle doen goed wat hulle nie gewoonlik sal doen nie.
Die kinders kry vandag kans om behoorlik petrolkop te speel. Elkeen kry 'n autentieke valhelm, baadjie en bril om die pad mee aan te durf. En natuurlik ry Brody heel voor, as gelukbringer. Almal is reg om te gaan, dit is my eerste keer hier.
Try and get as involved in the community as possible. You know, it's such a special privilege to be able to have this product in these bikes and this experience. What a wonderful reward, just be doing something you love and making people happy.
Die rede waarom hierdie alles begin het, Deidre, was oor jou seun Damien. Vertel my van hom.
He's my son Damien. He's 19 years old. He's physically disabled, but together we've had many adventures in his lifetime, and he's got such a spirit of adventure. He's keen for anything, and yeah, that was the aim of Warrior on Wheels, was to share those experiences with other children with disabilities.
Wat so goed doen jullie typisch met die kinders?
All sorts, zip lining, river rafting, horse riding, we've done helicopter rides, we do the Cape Town cycle tour with the kids being towed in buggies by able-bodied cyclists, theatre visits, visits to the aquarium, yeah, we just try and get them out experiencing life and letting them be kids. I know myself as a parent with a child with a disability, we can often go into survival mode, getting kids to school, making sure they have their medication every day, going from one doctor's appointment to the next therapy visit, that we need to sit back and think, you know, our kids need to be kids as well. They need to have the childhoods they deserve. If we think back on our own childhoods, climbing trees, riding bikes and stuff, and it shouldn't be any different for our kids. If you look on any of our photos on our website or anything like that, you'll just see the smiles. If you look at the kids today, they just, yeah, they really enjoy these experiences.
Wat beteken iets soos hierdie ervaring vandag vir hom?
Dit beteken die wêreld vir hom. I mean, hy kan nie soos ons able bodies op 'n bike klim en net ry saam met 'n pel nie. So ja, die ondervinding wat vir hom gebied word, is iets amazing.
Vian, het jy lekker motorfiets gery?
Ja.
Hoe het dit gevoel?
Mooi, lekker.
En is het lekker om die see te zien?
Ja.
Oeh, dit is zo mooi!
Zie je, hou van adventures. Zij wil net buiten wees. Zij ja. Nou gezien, ze wil alleen terug rijden.
En voor jou was het lekker op je motorfiets?
Ja, jy moet baie konsentreer en vashou, maar jy wil oral kyk. Maar het was fantasties. It's the experience of a lifetime. As a familie om saam alles te kan doen is fantasties.
Dave, hoe lang ry jy nou al saam met Sidecar Adventures?
Ek ry nou omtrent 11 jaar vir. Ek het soos 50.000 kilos gedoen sover.
Oor die algemeen, wat is mense se reaksies as hulle saam met julle ry?
Basies is hulle 'n bietjie onseker want hulle het dit nog nooit gedoen nie en ons moet hulle gerusstel. Hulle doen wat hulle noem die white knuckle, waar hulle vashou en dan kan ons sien soos hulle gewoond raak aan begin daai witheid weggaan, jy weet. Dit is baie spesiaal vir al vir my om die kinders te sien hoe hulle dit geniet.
Ja.
En vir my wat iets kan teruggee, jy weet ek is baie dankbaar om dit te kan doen.
Hoe raak gesinne betrokke by julle organisasie?
On our website we've got a sign-up form, so parents can go on and fill out their children's details, and then when we've got events we'll send out an invitation. It obviously depends how many children a specific provider can accommodate, and we take it from there. We launched with 3 children, we're now up to 70 families.
Yeah. En as iemand wil betrokke raak, as hulle nou vir 'n lekker avontuur wil bied, hoe kan hulle dit doen?
Also got a sign-up form on our website, or just pop us an email or a phone call. Always looking for new experiences, so we welcome the opportunity to partner and also just to showcase what we've got available in our city in terms of universal access. So I think it's a win-win situation for both the families and the service providers.
Almal verdien om pret te hê en op avonture te kan gaan. En danksy Tim, Deidre en Warrior on Wheels kon die kinders dit boonop in styl ook doen. Wel gedaan julle.